Hei, kia ora koutou katoa, ko ngongo taha te maunga, ko roto rua nui aka humata momo i te moana, ko te arawa te waka, ko te arawa te iwi, ko Ngāti Rangi Wewehi, Ngāti Whakaue, Ngāti Pikiao, Ngāti Tuaranga, Te Kea, ngā karangatanga hapū, ko Eraia Keel ahau. Kia ora koutou, greetings to all, my name is Eraia Keel. I hail from here, I'm a local boy, I'm a Rotorua boy, born and bred here in Rotorua. And I descend from the Te Arawa Confederation of Tribes. I come from all the many hapu that surround our beautiful lake, even out to Lake Rotoiti, and also stretch back to Horohoro. And love being brought up here in Rotorua. Culture has been my passion, culture, tourism, business, and connected with people from all walks of life. Kia ora koutou.
So thank you for that. Now tell me, why are you standing for council this year?
Yeah, I'm standing for council for many reasons. Well, one particular reason I'm standing is that I realise that everything rises and falls on leadership. And we need some strong leadership at the table. Having said that, I support the current leadership with Stevie Chadwick. I think she's done wonders for the city, and she's a very positive, strong role model for many of our people. Some of the current leadership around the council table, though, I think is not so positive. In fact, some of the things that have been out in the media of late has probably been highly negative rather than positive, and probably segregated our community a bit. So I believe that I bring, I'm young, vibrant, positive leadership that Te Arawa needs at the table, and that's basically it. I have some strong values that were instilled in me many, many years ago from some great leaders in the community, such as Mita Mohi, Trevor Maxwell, my own koro bully down the lakefront with his ponies. And those values is what we need at the table to bring our community together, because I think at the moment there's a lot of our community that are uneducated around particular issues. One big issue is partnership with iwi, and I bring a strong cultural voice to the table for the betterment of all of Rotorua.
Yeah, so that would be a key thing that you'd work on if you get elected?
If I get elected, that'll just be something I do naturally.
Yeah,
I'm not going in there to push leadership. It's just a natural rapport that I have in working with people, and I seem to sort of rub off on people, and that's what we do as Māori, as Te Arawa. That's what we've always done in the city. When our great grandfathers, great 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 grandfathers gifted the city, their motto was He Painga Mo Te Katoa, which translated it means goodness for everybody, goodness for everybody, not just Te Arawa. We've always been welcoming. Hence, Rotorua is one of the number one tourist destinations in New Zealand. So, those are some of the reasons. And you know, I want to impact this city positively. I want to leave a legacy for the future generations to come. I believe we have a huge potential in working with all the ethnicities in our country, especially here in Rotorua. And we probably don't realise how much we can learn from these other ethnicities. Such as our Asian brothers and sisters who have been around thousands and thousands of years longer than us. So very keen to be able to work with a diverse range of people, but very keen also on and making sure that our locals are well looked after, and we keep a lot of our employment locally, our education, obviously building on our tourism and our strong points, and in particular the environment as well.
Yeah, cool. So we have a couple of yes no questions for you on local issues where you stand. So the Green Corridor, the cycleway, do you support that?
Yeah, I like the Green Corridor, but I don't want the whole city to turn into a mountain bike track.
Oh, I haven't had that as an answer yet. Some of the mayoral candidates are campaigning that any rate increases should be kept at a maximum of 2% in the future. Do you support that?
Yeah, in a perfect world. In a perfect world, I'd say yes, but the reality is we won't know until we get in there and have a look at things.
Yeah. The health hub down at the library, do you support that?
The health hub down at the library. Anything to do with health, I support.
Yeah, sounds good. Obviously, the Te Arawa partnership.
Ooh, let me think about that.
This is the hard question. Yeah. Hey, everyone got asked this, so I had to ask you.
Yeah.
Yeah. And finally, just, you know, a little bit personal story about yourself. What's something people might like to know about you that they don't know?
Something you might like to know is I've been 4 days into my new role as the General Manager for the New Zealand Māori Arts and Crafts Institute at Te Puia. And just started on Monday and thoroughly enjoying the role. Three children, 11, 10 and four, and my four-year-old, she's the boss, mate.
Ah, well, if she could vote, she'd be voting for you.
But she says to everybody, keep it real, vote Keel.
Well, she's well-trained. Yeah. Well done. Hey, congratulations. Thanks. And all the best.
Thank you.